when you do the when they intercepting the fish team is trying to get that man with the quarterback.
Right.
You got to run this thing, and my linemen and all the rest of the tight end, whoever tight end, whatever. You got to be up there blocking these folks so they can get that ball to the end of that court and make a touchdown. But that's how it is with souls. Whatever God have you to pray for, whoever God have you prayed for, that's the soul in jeopardy.
Yeah.
You got to make a touchdown.
Yeah.
You got to give that soul to God.
Right.
And then, when I thought about this, I said, well, Lord, you know, when you're in that formation again, that defense is trying to figure out what play you finna play now.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Come on.
Y'all surprised like I know a little bit of this.
Yeah. Yeah.
I just I couldn't get the defense and the offense right, but I finally got it right. And my brother would let me keep playing with this. So, but the defense be trying to figure out what game y'all will play, y'all finna play now.
Right.
And so
right.
He looking. Sometimes the offense, we ain't got to give no kind of signal. We already talked about this in the game. We done played the game. We done did the strategy.
In the
okay. When I do such and such, you know, this out of eye movement or whatever. If I do like this, you know what's coming up.
That's right.
And so, like you can do the Statue of Liberty. And they do that run, and like they just throw them all off guard. But I thought about a game that we used to play when we were kids. Red Rover. Send Theresa right over. And we got a link here. We got people all lined up against us. And we're trying to find who's the weak link. And we're going to hit right there. And so that's how the devil is too.
Sure,
trying to find the weak spot.
Sure,
trying to find the weak spot.
Yeah.
That's right.
So.
Praise
God.
Praise God.
But you know what? At the same time, as I said, Satan trying to figure out what the weak link is. You know, James Bond used to have a song. Talking loud, but saying nothing. Remember that?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Well, that's how the devil is.
All right.
That's how the devil is. He's toothless. He's been defamed, and he just walk around and just got all he got was a roar. Roar. That's nothing. If we intercede and pray, we can bind him and call the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Plead the blood of Jesus.
Yeah.
He has to flee. He has to flee.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I thought about that and the football too. Remember what I told you, when the devil attacks and you lose something, you'll get it back. Now, sometimes on the defense side, when there's a penalty laid on them, the referee said, 10 yards!
Oh, Jesus.
And 10 yards is a thank you, Lord. Oh, fair side, we gained 10 yards. They lost 10.
Right.
So.
Amen.
That's how the Lord do us, but he gonna give us more than 10 yards.
That's right.
Yeah.
We be faithful and intercede.
Yeah.
And you know, he co-signed his word. God co-signed his word. He is true to his word.
Yes,
if he said it, you just might well get ready to accept it and believe it.
Amen.
And I'm going to be ready to bring it to a close. 2 Chronicles 7:14. We know what it says. If my people, which y'all call by my name, would humble themselves and pray, seek my face, and turn from the wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven, and I will forgive you your sins, our sins. That's we're talking right now. We're talking collective because of the body, for the body of Christ. Forgive our sins and heal our land. This land, that land out there, all the wickedness, all the killing, and all this going on. God will heal it if we will be on one accord for ourselves. And in Jeremiah 17:18, I'm sorry, Jeremiah 9:17-18. Thus said the Lord of hosts, consider and call the mourning women, not just the women, but the men as well, that they may come and send for skillful wailing women, men as well. that they may come. Let them make haste and take up a wailing for us, that our eyes may run with tears and our eyelids this with water. So finally, if we pray and intercede, God will hear our prayers.
Yes, he will.
And then he said,
already.
So finally, my brother, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this age, against spiritual wickedness, hosts of wickedness in heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil days. And having done all to stand, stand therefore, having girded your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench all fiery darts of the wicked ones, because he ain't gonna stop. He see you in a city, he's gonna try whatever he can. He's a tricky little spy rascal. Say he's a snake, so we gotta keep on praying.
Keep on
praying. And take on the helmet of salvation, the sword of the Spirit, which is the word, you know, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication, in the Spirit, being watchful of this end, with all preservation and supplication for all the saints, and for me, that utterance may be given to me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mysteries of the gospel. May God have his name.
Chuck's been up there for, say them loud, the wiles of the devil.
Backbiting, bitterness, gossip, hatred, and envy.
Listen to that. The wiles of, that's what we're gotta be able to get away from.
Amen.
No, go back, Jeremy. You gotta read the fiery darts.
Amen. Sickness, poverty, pain, and sin.
And God has made a way for us to have power. We got power when the Holy Ghost comes.
Right.
We don't have to be bothered with those things. If we're built up in the Lord, we can quench those fiery darts. We can, what is it that it says about the wiles of the devil?
Backbiting, bitterness, gossip, hatred, and envy.
Yes, but what does the scripture tell us about the wiles of the devil?
Put on the whole armor of God that we may be able to stand at the fire of the devil.
Okay, stand against the wiles of the devil and quench the fiery darts. That's powerful stuff.
Yes.
We don't wrestle. There is a war going on. It's a war going on.
Yes.
It's not the war we think. We aren't fighting against each other.
That's right.
We're fighting against those spiritual wickedness, against all the things that Satan has come to turn us around from serving the Lord.
Right.
So that was a powerful, powerful word. And we thank the Lord for it.
Amen.
So let's look at that and think about, what are the wiles of the devil? What are the fiery darts? Let's get them in our memory so we'll know when it confronts us, we're going to resist. We are going to to let him have his way. Amen, amen. Okay, we thank the Lord. We got one more speaker. And we're just enjoying ourselves mightily. We're eating proteins. I mean, when you're eating good stuff, you're eating protein, something that's going to build you up. But we're getting a little bit of dessert, too. So we thank the Lord for the fruits, the vegetables, the desserts, and all of it. And so now we're calling for Sister Joanne. Who's going to introduce you? Okay, we're going to call Brother David Alexander to come and introduce his sister, Missionary Joanne Williams.
Thank the Lord for being here, and let's just give the Lord a hand praise. We just thank the Lord for Sister Joanne Williams. I called so many people in my family, and to be honest with you, I don't know where these sorry people are. But you have to go on in the Lord. You have to go on in the Lord, because so many times you have to learn how to go by yourself. And I called, and I called. And they said they were going to try to come, and I didn't see nobody but me. But we thank the Lord for Sister Joanne. She's there for everybody in our family all the time.
Praise God.
And she's such a prayerful person. She's her and my mother that passed, her and my mother and Olivia, they used to pray for hours. I come home from school, they still be praying. And they used to pray so hard. And I said, my goodness. No, we couldn't get in no trouble because the prayers of the saints were going up for us steadily. And my sister Joanne, I call her sometime, and she go to quoting so many scriptures. And she go talking about the word is beautiful. And I say, sometime, can you talk about something different? I'm just going to be honest. I say, can you talk about something different? How's the weather outside? Because I enjoy the word. I love the word. But I mean, sometimes you call it, and she go to those scriptures. Her and Tony be talking about the word. And she go on and on. And I say, okay, Joanne, I thank the Lord for you. But what else happened today? I'm not trying to sound carnal, but we just thank the Lord for her. But she is so Bible-minded, and we just she praying for the family all the time. So we just thank the Lord for her, and I just want y'all to welcome Sister Missionary Joanne Williams.
Another like we say we're doing.
He that dwelleth in the
91st Psalm, starting with 1.
Yeah.
He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Yes.
Yes.
If we intercess for one another, like we're supposed to do, we will be able to abide under the shadow of God. You can tell when people, we do it, we're doing real excellent in this church. But you can tell when people are abiding under the shadow of the Almighty, because God just shows it in your interactions with each other.
Jesus, that's good.
And the second it says, the second verse says, I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. That's what intercession for one another do for you.
Yes.
You will learn how to trust, really trust God when you're having trouble. Surely He shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He does that for us. He delivers us. We have testimonies of people being delivered from pestilence and stuff. But He said, now here's a strong point here. 1,000 shall fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee.
Yeah.
And we, how many of us get in accidents and stuff where we get killed, and you don't see none of our members on the in the newspaper. You know why? Because intercession. It's people in this church. I'm the one who pray for everybody. I praise all day, and I ask the Lord everybody that passed through that door. Bless them. I bind Satan for them. Everybody that passes through those doors, so that devil won't be able to tear them to pieces, because that's what he's doing now. He is tearing people to pieces now. And then he said, because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, your habitation. That's what we're doing when we intercess. When you intercess and let God know that, hey, you're everything to me. You're my house. You're my, you know, you're my fortress, my high tower. You're everything that I need. Then he knows that he's your refuge and he's your habitation, and he will deliver you from everything that Satan tries to destroy you of. I know somebody was intercessing for me this week, and I got a suspicion it was Elder and Sister Burrell's, because the devil attacked me with asthma attack.
Glory.
And trying to bring asthma back on me, and I've been delivered from asthma. And I said, I don't know what I'm going to do.
Glory.
Because I don't believe in medicine, really, which is, I'm hearing a lot of stuff in our meetings that you need to, it's some medicine you got to take. You got to have medicine. You just got to take that medicine. Anyway, this is a funny story about my medicine. I've been paying a copay of $7 for the inhaler. Okay, I went to the thing, to the pharmacy, and the pharmacist said, your copay now is $28. I'm not kidding you all. Is it possible to get healed on the spot?
Yeah.
I felt like I had to go. I felt like it went away when he said $28. And I walked away from there healed. I'm not going to lie to you. I was healed for a long time after he told me about the $28. But then I called Cole. I fooled around and called Cole.
Yeah.
And now I went back and he said my copay was $40. And I said, Lord, this devil is just getting out of hand. And I said, I just refused to pay him $40. And the Lord knew I wasn't going to change my mind, so he made my brother Norman give me his inhaler. Norman gave me a brand new inhaler. But the Lord is, he will cover you if people is intercessing for you. When people are, you can tell when people is praying for you. You can tell when people are praying for you. Because the Lord just delivers you from stuff. All of a sudden, you know, you'd be delivered. anyway, he said, we're down to the 10th. There shall no evil befall you, neither shall any plague come nigh your dwelling. Wouldn't that be nice if we was intercessing for each other so much till no plagues came near our dwelling? And, you know, that was, and he said, for he shall give his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. Now, the angels have charge over us to keep us in all of our ways. But if we're intercessing, they're going to do their job better.
Glory.
If we're intercessing, saying, Lord, send angels to, like Sister Teresa, I be sending angels. I tell the Lord, send some angels. If she having any trouble after that dialysis, send some angels to lift that off her. And different ones that have stuff going on with them, I be praying for the Lord to send angels to help them. If you're intercessing, I'm not kidding you. We could change this whole city.
That's right.
If we start doing something, we can change this whole city. For he shall give his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. Now, if you pray on your own, the Lord will do this. You know, the 91st Psalm. But I'm just talking about what would happen if we really intercess for one another like we're supposed to. It said, his angels shall bear you up in their hands, lest you dash your foot against the stone. Thou shalt tread on the lion and the adder. Now, this is what we really have to intercess for. Treading on the lion and the adder. That adder is a poison, a deadly poisonous snake. And the lion, the big lion here that is referring to in verse 13 is the big principalities and powers that be fighting against you, be cutting people down with cancers and stuff. That's those big principalities. And he said, you will tread on them. You'll tread on them. In other words, you'll disturb their little program. Huh? But the young lion and the serpent or the dragon, you shall trample them under your feet. And now, we supposed to be doing that anyway. We're supposed to be trampling demons under our feet as we go along. But the Lord will cause it to you to be more successful if you're intercessing. I'm telling you, this intercession is something else. See, at the beginning of this chapter, it said, if you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, you got to stay before God. Oh, stay there. Stay. You can't get up and you say, okay, I will pray for him. I'm sick of praying. I'm going to get up from here.
Right.
I'm going to get me something good to eat because, you know, I like to eat good food. Anyway, he said, if you dwell or stay in the secret place of the Most High, you will abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And so I'm telling you, I'm nosy. I'm watching to see. And if I don't think you intercessing enough, I'm going to get some of my friends at different churches to intercess with me in my house. Because I want this church, which is about the best church I've known. I want this church to get to intercess so much for each other until you can feel when somebody is having a hard time. Man, even here, you can feel it. Because that's what the old saints used to do. You come to church, you be sitting up there, sister, why was you out? I was a little sick. The Lord told me. And they tell you what was wrong with you without you telling them what was wrong with you. So this comes by intercession.
Yes.
He said, because you have set your love on God, he will deliver you and he will set you on high because you have known his name. Now, wouldn't you all want to be set on high? No, God done set me up on high just because I've been praying for sisters and brothers. You know, this salvation is a beautiful thing. Don't you know when the Lord gives Sister and Elder Burrell's, a doctor and Elder Burrell, when he gives them those special messages, he means for us to take the messages and run with them. You know, in our private life, run with those messages because one day, one day we gonna see him face to face. Yes. I done had a whole lot of friends die. In 2010, I had four friends, Missionary Richmond, Rufus Walker, Robert Rosborough, and it was another one. Oh, Sister Idella Brown. Yes. All of them passed away right at the end of 2010.
Glory.
But I didn't worry about them because they were people that prayed, yes, and they was kind, yes, and meek and humble, yes, and they didn't backbite, you know, people and stuff. So I wasn't even worried about them. I was, you know, the death of a saint is a beautiful thing. It's really a saint, you know. Yeah, it is. If you're a saint, it's a beautiful thing. Okay, I'm at the end. God said, when he calls upon me, I will answer him. Now, don't you want to tell me? Is it anybody in here don't want their prayers answered? When you call on him, he will answer you. That's beautiful. And he said, I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. Now, I'm going to tell you something. This intercession is something. You all got a chance. We doing good. That good ain't good enough. Don't y'all think y'all doing good enough. I be telling you all, I'm not trying to put nobody down. I be saying, you ain't good, but that's not what I mean. I mean, as good as we are, we got to do better. We always got to be striving to do better. And so this can be done by intercession. I love all of you all. I'm going to tell you, you can think what you want to about me. I'm praying for you. So that's just what God has given me for today. I don't have no great message.
Doing it collectively,
glory,
said even national problems can be corrected. Yeah. When we're together on it. And didn't the word tell us that when the people are one, there is nothing that they can't do? Nothing. So it's wonderful to have collective intercession. And then if that seems things just aren't getting, put a little fasting in there with it. Amen. Oh, God is so good. And he can remind us of so much through each vessel. He just deals with us in just various ways. He's just a wonderful God. So let's remember that. When we see things, we don't have to be told. When we see things out of order, whatever, just begin to pray. That's the nature of being Christ-like. He wants us to pray. So we just do it automatically when we see things. Amen. God is so good. And remember that he's greater in us. No matter what Satan is doing, carrying on, God is greater in us. And the scripture said when he comes, when Satan comes in like a flood, what did it say? The Spirit of the Lord is going to lift up a standard against it. I mean, we're winners no matter how we look at it. If we quote that word and walk in righteousness, that word, if we just get it in us, we'll believe it. We'll believe it. And we'll be able to stand on it. So we got to dwell in the Lord. Like she said, we got to dwell in that place. Got to be consistent. Got to be persistent. Got to just stay there. Just stand no matter what. Oh, our God is good. And think about it. He's given us power to do it. That same power that he had to overcome, it's abiding right in us.
Yes.
Oh, God is a wonderful God. So we've had the mighty, mighty word tonight.
Amen.
And God has just been good to us. And we're so thankful. He's a good God. So we want to do our offering. So we're going to ask whoever did devotion to come in and do our offering. Amen. And then we're going to see if our visitors, if we have any visitors. Yes, we do have a visitor, to see if our visitor want to share with us, to say, have remarks, testify.
Let us all stand. Father, we thank you once again for your many blessings. We thank you.
bless this offering that we're about to receive. Those that have and don't have, praise them. We pray, Father. Amen.
I just thank the Lord for being back at Holy Ghost, and I guess I can say tonight, thank the Lord for being back home at wanting to make Holy Ghost back my home church.
Amen. Praise God.
The best.
pass. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. He's going to prepare a place for us that we can be with him. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. We're in air. Can you imagine being in air of our great big God and join ears with the sun?
That's right.
Oh, I tell you, he loves us. He loves us. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And he's chosen every one of us. Chosen us. Oh, I thank the Lord. I thank the Lord. He's awesome in all of his ways. Amen. We're just so glad for everything that has been done this night. We want to ask Sister Shirley Smart if she want to have words. Amen. We're so glad that she came to be with us tonight.
Praise the Lord. You know, I always feel at home when I come here. And it's a great thing to be among the saints of God.
Yes, it is.
Y'all know y'all are blessed.
Yeah.
You are anointed. But the Bible said the kingdom, the sister was saying there's a war going on.
Yes.
The kingdom suffer violence, but the violent takes by force.
Yes.
We got to become violent in our intercessory.
Yes.
We got to come violent in our prayer. And Sister Donna said, our battle, he said, the word of God said, we wrestle not against flesh and blood. It is not with each other. It's against spiritual wickedness in high places. In high places. And I just praise God because you know what? I believe that the people here tonight, you have been touched by God. There's a lot of people getting prepared tonight to go out to the club. But God has filled us our cups tonight. He has filled us up with the word so we can go out and destroy the kingdom of darkness. Sometimes the kingdom of darkness is right in your home, your neighborhood, the place where you work. The Bible said he's giving you power, Sister Teresa said. He's given us power to tread over scorpions and devils. And no enemy power shall overtake you. What is against you today? What can be against you, Romans said. I feel like preaching now, but I'm going to sit down. This word has been great, and I've been filled with the Spirit tonight.
Now, are there any needs? We never like to close the service without prayer for anybody that feel like they need prayer. Anybody want to give their heart to the Lord? If there's anybody not saved, are there any needs? Amen. Brother James.
I'd just like to ask the church to continue to pray for me because I do believe in people interceding for you.
Yeah.
Because some of the stuff I've been through, if it hadn't been for my church family praying for me, I'll surely be on the other side somewhere.
Praise God.
Now I know where I'm at. Here, able to pray.
Amen.
Praise God. Praise God.
We have a few announcements. I know that the Making Strides Against Breast Cancer Walk is tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. We start at 9 o'clock. Oh, I forgot to get the t-shirts out of my husband's car. I have a t-shirt for everybody that's going to walk, and I'll bring them in the morning. We were planning to come together, but it didn't work out that way, and I forgot to get the box out of his car. The walk is 2.5 miles, so it's short.
3 miles.
3 miles, okay, 3 miles.
3.2 or 5.
What was that from 9 to about 11?
You can
walk
fast. No. Come on, Tim. 3 miles, 20 minutes tops.
So we're doing good in our contributions.
2 miles.
In what we're going to contribute. Is there anybody else that want to give?
Make it 30.
That want to give for the American Cancer Society. I pledged $150 for us. And more. But if there's anybody else that want to give, I'm accepting donations. The walk is going to be downtown on Saginaw Street, the lot, the flat surface lot right across. It's at Kersley and Saginaw. Kersley, right by the U of M Pavilion, that lot, flat lot right across there.
2 miles, about 14 minutes. What time is it?
It's at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Registration open at 7:30 if you want to come register.
Right.
If you haven't registered.
Right. If you if you plan to walk and you haven't registered.
18, 20. Okay. Let's remember to pray for, well, continue to pray for John Person.
He wanted prayer.
What's John?
Okay.
Yeah, that's how ladies pray for John. He needs for his family.
We're going
to, intercede for his family.
Amen. And are there any other announcements before we pray this week?
Okay. I'd just like to say Christmas dinner is coming up, and different ones have been giving me money for their dinner. So if anyone would like to give money, you don't have to pay the whole 25 at once or whatever. Like a layaway plan, I'm doing it, and I got a record. I'm keeping a good straight record of who gives what. So if you want to start that, I'll appreciate it. And I do have the prices for the children. I'll give it to you later.
And while Minister Riley is coming, I'd like to see Elder and Sister Allen, Elder James and Sister Angela. Let me see, was there anybody else on our team last year? Okay. Oh, and Deacon Andrews. My husband's brother, Willie, lost everything in a house fire, too, on this week. So,
also, First Lady, Missionary Alicia, is that her name, Alicia? Felicia. Felicia is going to be here with the fourth Sunday at 4 o'clock. And also, Jeremy asked me to announce that Deliverance will be in concert next Saturday at 6 o'clock at St. Paul Missionary Baptist Church. Also, I wanted to remind the saints that I interviewed Sister Naomi Monday. She's going to be on television at 8 o'clock, so tune in. You don't want to miss that. And I'm telling Brother David ahead of time, I want to interview him. I want him to sing and sing and sing. Amen. Praise the name of God. Sing to the glory of God. And if you want to get a DVD, I've interviewed Brother James and his wife. I have DVDs available. I'm telling you, God is up to something bigger than we are. Amen. Praise God. Come on, we're going to pray for our brother Johnny. And I want to pray for John, too. He doesn't feel well. He's resisting going to the hospital. I'm letting him do his thing. But he needs a miracle. He needs a miracle from God. He needs to be hospitalized.
Your husband, John.
My husband, John, yes. So come on, Brother Johnny, we're going to pray with you. We're going to stand with you, brother. We all in this together.
One more announcement. Tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock, Evangelist Paulette Strong will be here with the Healing and Deliverance Crusade. So let's come out and support her tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock. Then whoever, one of the speakers, would you come, please, to dismiss us after the prayer?
Amen.
You are his friend.
Father God, we thank you. We thank you for your word, God. We thank you for life. We thank you for the strength, God. God, we ask you to teach us how to pray. You know, and teach us what to say and how to say it, God. Let us be interceders for one another, God. And that we may do it collectively and in unity, God. God, stir us, God. Oh, God, don't let the word go out void, God. Oh, God, we ask you to disturb everything that is not like you. We'll root it up and pluck it up, God, and we'll thank you. God, we ask you to look on Brother Robert's sister Doris. Lord, we ask you to touch her body. We think she has surgery today, God, but we're believing in the victory. It's already done, and she's healed in Jesus' name. God, we just ask you to look on each individual that's here today. We ask you to comfort them, keep them as they go to their several homes and places. And we ask you just to watch over them. And we ask you to look on Sister Ruthie, Lord, you know, the condition, God. Hallelujah. We claim her healing in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we just ask you to watch, God. Look over the family, God. Strengthen us, keep us in your care, God. And we'll be forever careful to give you the praises and the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.